Hello friends, welcome back to Magic Knight Rayearth. Once again, a lot has happened, so I think it's a good idea to start the episode with a little recap. Number 6, so I think there's 2 new entries per person, yeah. Alright.
When we left the Forest of Silence, Alcione showed up again. Umi called on her magic ability to drive her away, and Fu used her magic ability to heal the injuries Ferio got in the fight. All we have to do now is make a mad dash for the Spring of Eterna.
I thought Hikaru had eyes for Ferio, but now I'm certain that it's Fu that has the Gaga eyes for him. When he knelt and kissed Fu's hand, I'm positive Fu blushed. We don't have time for romance. This is gonna be a problem. I can feel it.
Ferio risked his own life to shield me from Alcyon's magic. Needless to say, I'm a little flushed just thinking about it. He actually ended up getting hurt on my account. What a hunk. I wonder if this is romance novel love or the real thing. In fact, I wonder how I'd know. My head hurts.
When we got to the spring, I saw Flash! But something was wrong because he tried to attack me. At first I was frightened because I thought he didn't recognize me anymore. But then I realized he was some kind of evil beast that took Flash's form. I wish I could see my dog for real. I miss him so much.
I had the weirdest experience. What appeared to be my mother and father trying to attack and kill me. But I soon realized it was a clever trick. Fortunately, Princess Emerald helped me to survive. Hikaru and Fu had some kind of weird experience too. After it all though, we managed to get the escudo.
I had the most peculiar experience. It seems that when we made it to the spring, Umi, Hikaru, and I entered into some kind of bizarre dreams. In mine, I was attacked by an evil doppelganger. Fortunately, we all managed to overcome the trial and get the escudo. I don't know if I can keep this up.
And while I'm at it, let's check in with Clef. Oh right, this one isn't voice acted. I have to take the reins here. Now that you've secured the escudo, you must return to Prisha. She needs the escudo to create your special aura weapons. And that's probably it. Yeah. Sometimes there's a second thing. Usually not. Alright, Fu. No plot teleport back to Prisha, unfortunately. We gotta hoof it. But that means we get to hear the forest music again. Which is very nice. Everyone all healed up from the encounter? Yeah, that's good. So, no magic in the Forest of Silence. Which makes sense. Grab a couple gemstones. I'm sure they'll come in handy for something eventually. Okay, it's only 4 hits, not 5. Still slightly excessive. It's a good thing they are- ooh! That was a big one. It's a good thing they're so susceptible to being stunned. Otherwise, they would be a minor nuisance. Pretty confident. Ooh, another big one. Pretty confident in my combat abilities so far. Alright, we're back at the crazy spinning sign. So, It is quite possible that there is treasure or something that I'm missing in the Forest of Silence, because the layout is confusing and non-Euclidean. So there may be directions that I haven't gone or will not go. Hopefully not. I mean, I would like to collect all of the rainbow amulets and unlock the fun bonus modes if possible. Okay, so if the arrow is pointing that direction, well, if I go the direction of the arrow, won't that lead us back to the spring? But I feel like I tried the other direction, so let's see what happens. I could use magic to dispatch the Tektite monsters a little more easily. Yeah, that just loops back around. Okay. So I need to figure out what's going on with the sign. Maybe if I head this direction when it's spinning. Okay, that just takes me back out that way. If I do it again, does it repeat that? Yeah. Huh. Oh, I think I might have found it. So, this is that area where the two paths become two dead ends. So, not missing anything there. It turns into an... Okay, that also turns into two dead ends. Interesting. You can aim and move diagonally, which I haven't been doing a lot of. It's just easier to line up shots in the four cardinal directions. Oh right, I can't use magic, it's the Forest of Silence. Whatever was I thinking? Anything fun over here? Okay. I think that loops back to the two dead end area. See if I can lose Umi and Hikaru. I mean, they're just weighing Fu down. Fu's the MVP. Ah! The exit. Defeat one more Tektite for the road. Sorry, I need to pause the recording just one moment. Alright, sorry about that. So we are back here at Precious Manor. Door to the east, still locked. I don't like scary things either. Love that door sound effect. Anything new in this bed and breakfast room? No, nothing. What's up, Precia? I don't believe my eyes. Escudo, you've retrieved the Escudo. You three are truly the legendary Magic Knights. Rest assured, I will do everything I can to make the perfect escudo weapons. You are all quite fortunate to have me available. Escudo cannot be shaped by just anyone. Maybe this game doesn't voice as much of the dialogue as I remember. I shall return soon. Remember, no peeking. Let me peek. Aww. It's okay. I don't mind reading aloud. Ooh. We get to see what the baddies are up to.
Say God, my Lord, please forgive me. I underestimated their strength. I was unprepared, but next time I'll surely...
Silence. There shall not be a next time, dear Alcione.
What? Say God, please! I'm begging you! Just give me one more chance! Master, say God! Please! No!
What a gem this one turned out to be. Alcione was never suited to the task at hand. Zagat, there's still a chance to stop them. Send me, and I'll show them how we play.
Very well, Ascot. Do not return without favorable news.
Okay then. I don't feel super threatened watching that, but we'll see what happens. Hello again. I think you'll find these weapons were well worth the wait. This is it? That's right. These are the weapons of the Magic Knights. They have been made just for you. No one else can use them. If you head northeast, you will soon reach the ocean. Why don't you start there? So are the new weapons reflected in my... Oh, so under the portrait there it says Escudo level 1. I suppose that was level 0 before. Okay, well once I get to a battle zone, I can see what the new weapons look like. Same. Aw, I can't go into the secret weapon zone. Alright, northeast. That's convenient, that was the only direction I was able to go. Anything up here? Anything new? New developments? Can I use this cannon yet? Nope. Okay. That's right, you don't get the cannon until like 10 hours into the game. I assume. So, from Precious Manor to Polizu Village. At least it doesn't make me fight my way there. Although it would be nice to have a chance to see what the new weapons do shortly after acquiring them. Ooh, spooky. You scared the living daylights out of me. What was with that dialogue effect? Those trees were making the emulator chug a bit. This fountain is flowing with energy. If you drink from it, your strength will be restored. Oh, I wonder if the fountain in Preacher's Manor does that too. Maybe it's just not doing anything right now because I'm not hurt. Is that a windmill? Okay, you can just step off into the water, I guess. It doesn't hurt, it just kinda makes you flash and resets your position. That's like a rotating stained glass window or something. That's really cool. Also, this appears to be some sort of item shop, maybe? That's what that sign is? Accept gems in exchange for magical restorative items. Okay, so they're gems. No fancy currency name. Not yet. Let's wait and see if there's anything better to spend my gems on. Aww. I love when old games have emoji. Emojums. Yeah, like, well, also, I only have 46 gems, so I couldn't buy either of those if I wanted to. But in general, I like to save my currency for more kind of permanent benefit items or objects, trinkets. Oh, cannot jump across there. Can I get a running jump? No. Maybe if I run around in circles a little bit first? No, you kind of have to go in a straight line for a while before you get up to run speed. Ray just explaining the fountain to me. Never fear, the Magic Knights are here. Ma'am, we have everything under control. Just leave it to the Magic Knights. Very astute. Unlike other JRPG and adjacent game protagonists, they won't just rifle through random people's drawers and cabinets. Little stove-like thing. How neat. I still haven't had my snacks. It must not be too important. Yeah, as far as I know, that's just background dressing. I don't think that comes up at any point during the game. Like I don't think you read the note or read the diary or whatever. Just little touches that make the world feel more lived in. I like quiet men. Sorry for the crunchiness. Hello. Okay. So he's a swimming teacher? Oh, that's right. They can't read the language. They can only look at the pictures. Big, heavy wood. And is this just the same kitchen monologues? No? So much text in this game. Okay, it's just all the same. Oh no! This sounds like a job for the Magic Knights. Hello, so are we. I've heard of that. Oh. I'm listening. I just can't test my weapons right now. Invisible wall. Or maybe this is the barrier. It's just an invisible barrier. Hey, excuse me. Hello, how do you do, ladies? Are you having a good time? Well, I was, but you're the guy from the cutscene. The Magic Knight should just, like, punch this guy. Well, I guess they didn't see the cutscene. They should really be paying attention to that stuff. I don't know, Umi. Why don't you look in the jar? Ooh. Legendary reputation. Yeah, you look like a security guard type. Oh, is Lucchino the village chief? Ah, no, this is Lucchino, the greatest spellcaster in all of Sephiroth. The villagers love me because I created a special barrier to keep monsters away, but monsters have managed to get past the barrier, and now my reputation is in jeopardy. Alright, same kitchen dialogue there. Lucchino likes to talk big, but he's not nearly as big as he'd like everyone to believe. Somehow he managed to create a barrier to protect this village, which sent his ego soaring. But recently a monster showed up that had the strength to break Lucchino's barrier. All the villagers are relying on him, but there's nothing he can do about the situation. Thanks, Lucchino's wife. I like it too. Eep. All right. Time to visit with the village chief. For we, the magic knights, can solve this village's barrier problem. I mean, I assume. Check out this tent first. Ooh, fortune teller? Wuzuzu! When you lose your way, I can show you the way. There are two books from which I can divine your future, ladies. Use or lose. Sure, I'll spend 5 gems. Tell me what's in the moon book. Fine. Moment, please. Wah! Oh, ha! Wazaza! I've got it! Look around and ask of strangers. You'll find new things to cause you danger. Wuzuzu! Did you find that useful? Come back if you get stuck again. Well, I'm definitely not paying 20 gems for the sun fortune now. Like, walk around and talk to people. Thanks. Aw. We do. Literally every day, as far as this LP is concerned. Never talked to this dude. There's a cave located just north of this here village. That's where them dread monsters are hiding. I like the informal language, hiding with the apostrophe, stuff like that. Working Designs is good at character, at charm. Sometimes they can go a little overboard. But this game has been mostly, like, the localization has been mostly good so far. Sorry, it's too dangerous outside the village. Alright, I saw something that looked like a magic barrier over here. Is that what that was? Yeah, it's all wavy and has an air of menace about it. Oh, this house has been, like, messed up. Looks like a meteorite hit it or something. Alright, let's talk to the chief and then I'll call it for this episode. Ever since the monsters began attacking our village, we've been in grave danger. We asked Lucino to protect us by creating a barrier to block them out. But the darn thing isn't enough, and recently we've had more monster activity than usual. If we don't do something soon, the village will be lost. I'll talk to you soon, old man. I have to admire your tableware first. Very nice stuff. Hello. Welcome. I am the chief of Polizu, and I've got quite a dilemma on my hands. Is that Italian for chief of police? Chief of Polizu. I think it's Polizzi in Italian, I'm not sure. Monsters from the Tempting Cave have been attacking our village, and we are defenseless. The legend said that when Sephiroth was in danger, 3 magic knights would show up. I'm not one for legends, but oh, do I ever wish that this one would come true. If these magic knights were to suddenly appear, what would you ask of them? My button's stuck. Sorry. I would ask them to create a new barrier, even stronger than Lucino's, to protect us. I'm sorry, but we haven't yet learned any magic that could create such a barrier. Hikaru? What did you just say? Wait a minute. There are 3 of you. No, it couldn't be. Ooh, there's 3 of them. We were sent forth by the High Priest Clef to save the land of Sephiroth. Clef? Great, rods of lightning. They are real. But mere children? And you cannot create the barrier? We may not be able to create a barrier, but if you wish, we'll go through the cave and fight for you. You would take that risk for us? Hikaru, what are you saying? We're supposed to be searching for those machine things. Prisha told us that our next destination should be the Northern Sea. No? Yes, but I cannot leave here while these innocent people are in need of our help. But we don't have a lot of time. Now, Umi. Yes, it's important for us to seek out the machines, but don't forget what else Prisha said. For our weapons to grow into the keys that revive the machines, our wills must grow too. Well, yes, that's true. At this point, we really don't know how our weapons and our very hearts will grow. But if we try to do good by helping out like this, we may come closer to finding out. So, do you think that this might be the way? We've got nothing to lose by attempting to find out. So what's the verdict? We can't promise you that we'll meet your expectations, but we'll certainly try our best. Marvelous. Fear not. I've got faith in you, girls. Alright then, let's hit the road. And let's hit the road in this episode. Tune in tomorrow when the Magic Knights will brave the ancient cave and find out what is down that staircase. Thanks for watching, everyone. Goodbye.